Welcome to another season of City Connector right here on City TV and brought to you by the City of Douglasville. I'm Lee Brogdon-Culberson of ProfessionalMojo.com, and I think this might be my third year of hosting this fabulous program. It is always such an honor to live here, to work here, to own a business here, and I know that you appreciate it too. We have a wonderful show coming up for you, so I want you to grab that hot cup of coffee and stay tuned because we'll be right back. Welcome back to the show. Our first guest is Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Gordon Pritz. Welcome back to City Connector.
Thank you. Always great to be here, and we appreciate the opportunity.
We are glad to have you. Now, before we talk about what I would like to talk about, we have some really fabulous statistics that just came out talking about how successful the school system really is in Douglas County. So why don't you talk to us about that first?
Well, thank you. We really appreciate the opportunity to talk with y'all, and anytime we can share our story and share some good news, it's always a good thing. But we're real excited about some of the news coming out of the State Department back in late fall. Both we received information, of course, on our ACT scores and our SAT scores, which were both up again in improvement over the previous year. And then on our graduation rate, we got some great news when that was released by the state. We were up 12.5%.
Wow.
Over the previous year, up to 88.2% of our students graduating. So that is tremendous gains and tremendous news, and it actually makes us the second highest graduation rate in the area of school districts our size or larger.
And I was going to ask how that compares, generally speaking. So the second best.
Second best, and of course, we're real proud of that.
That's wonderful. Well, what we're going to talk about in a minute, I think, has something to do with the fact that we're making big gains in these areas. But from your perspective, what do you think maybe the top two or three things that really contributed to what we've seen, that 12.5% increase?
Well, number one, we have a lot of great programs in place. Our number one priority, of course, is to graduate all our students from high school. And so we have a number of support programs in place to help them along the way, to help them find their niche, if you will. And so a lot of these programs have been put in the last couple of years, and we just think a lot of it came together at the right time. And it's a result of a lot of hard work by our teachers and our students, and of course the support of our parents.
Well, congratulations to you and the entire district. That's great news.
Thank you.
And thank you for sharing it here on City Connector.
You bet.
All right. Now, along those lines, part of the reason why you're able to have these fabulous programs and we have wonderful things in our system has a lot to do with the ESPLOST. Now, there's a vote on the ESPLOST coming up on March 1st of this year, but I'd like for you to share with people who are maybe new to the area what is ESPLOST and how has it been used in the past?
Well, thank you. Georgia has a provision that local communities, counties, can pass a 1 cent sales tax. And we have done that in Douglas County for four consecutive periods of time, 5 years each. And so our fourth ESPLOST is coming due at the end of this year. And so we are going to the voters in March, as you said, March 1st, to ask the voters to consider approval of a fifth ESPLOST. This would be a continuation.
Right, it's nothing new. It's something that we've been having for four times now.
Right, and it's very, very important to the school district. It is another source of revenue that allows us to run the school system. As everybody knows, we've gone through terrible recession, and the school system was hit very hard by that. Had it not been for the ESPLOST dollars coming in, we would have had to make even more cuts than we have. The great advantage to the ESPLOST is it's very defined on how it's to be used.
Well, let's talk about that for a second. How has the money been used? Just a few example projects in the past, and what are some of your plans if it passes again?
Well, we have been able to use it for capital improvements, which is buildings and renovations, and we've added some new school buildings as needed. We also used bond money, which is another way to get money quickly to build. And when the district was in its throes of very fast, rapid growth, they had to use bond referendums to get that done. But the ESPLOST allows us to use that money to build and renovate. It allows us to use that money for technology, computers, interactive whiteboards in the classrooms.
Very important.
Right. And so we've been able to do that. And probably one of the most important things it allows us to do is to pay off bond debt. Those bonds that we had to borrow, we use the SPLOST dollars to pay that off. And we've been able to pay off a huge amount of money over the years using SPLOST dollars.
I also noticed that you can purchase replacement buses. And I think that it also, when you say capital projects, I want to be clear that our viewers know, it includes things like building schools when we need those schools, right? Chapel Hill High, Factory Shoals Middle School, Holly Springs.
Right. All examples of buildings that we've been able to do because of SPLOST. But it does, it is very defined on how we're to use it. In fact, it's probably one of the most regulated taxes that we have. And so that should make our citizens feel good that the money will be defined exactly how it's going to be used. In fact, they can go on our website right now and pull up all the lists of projects that will be done with this, should it pass in March.
Right.
And we are able to keep up with our growing population of students in the district through SPLOST.
And I would tell them, too, that you have a PDF out there on the site that has everything very well enumerated out there. You'll be able to see precisely what it's been used for in the past, the debt reduction we've talked about, the addition and renovations, all of those things are listed out there.
We have that document that you pointed out on our website, front and center. We have a DVD that shows a lot of that and mm-hmm. talks a lot about this, that anybody can visit our website and click on and get all that information and be ready to go March 1st for that vote.
And by the way, speaking of that, there is February advance voting in person. So I want to make sure that people who might not be in town for the March 1st and maybe who want to have their voice heard on this particular issue, you can do advance voting Monday, February 8th through Saturday, February 20th, 8 to 5 at the Douglas County Courthouse, and February 22nd and February 26th at the courthouse. So no reason why someone who's interested in the education system, the school system, can't go and vote on this topic.
And it is certainly a support to the school system, but as I mentioned, the ability to use this money to pay off bond debt
right.
is extremely important to the taxpayers, because this is another way of paying down that debt. In fact, we were able to lower the bond millage 3 mils over the last 5 years using this money instead of tax digest money or money on homeowners. Mm-hmm. And so it also allows folks who come and visit our county from outside to help pay for some of that. So we just think it's a very wise way and a very frugal way to pay down our responsibilities with our bond debt.
Well, wonderful. Well, thanks so much, Dr. Pritz, for being on the show, keeping us informed, and I hope the folks will go out and make their voice heard. Come back and see us again.
Thank you so much, as always.
All right. Well, we're going to go on out to the interactive community calendar, so you stay tuned, and we'll be right back.
Well, welcome to the Interactive Community Calendar, the first one for the year 2016.
Yeah.
Welcome, Sarah.
Thanks.
We're back at Arbor Place Mall and ready to tell everyone about everything coming up in our community. Who do we have first?
We have our friend Vonda Thorpe here, and she is wearing a different bow, as we were talking about before we went on camera. And she is here for Beyond the Front Porch today with two big events that are coming up.
Yes, we have two great events coming up. February the 13th, we're going to Birmingham, Alabama for the largest in the nation Civil Rights Museum.
Awesome.
So we still have availability, so you can check us out on our website, Beyond the Front Porch, and see mm-hmm. more information about it. As well as on March the 26th, and this is a very exciting event.
This one's really cool.
Yeah, this is cool. It's a fundraiser for Beyond the Front Porch. It's the Battle of the Candidates. So the sheriffs were the soon-to-be, one of them will be a sheriff, but we'll find out who's going to battle out on the bowling alley. So everyone's welcome to show up, show your support for your favorite candidate, and it's going to be at Thunder Zone March 26th from 10 until 1:30.
Right, that's
perfect.
Great.
And do people have to pay to come and spectate or just
on? Come cheer them on. They'll have to pay. But
got
you can
it.
Always make donations to Beyond the Front Porch, because that's basically what it is. It's a fundraiser to help more children go on more trips.
Great. Yeah. Thank you so much.
And Vonda, you wear many bows, as you ladies made reference to throughout our community. So thank you for bringing Beyond the Front Porch to us today. And also, well, I'm sure we'll see you back around with Raise the Praise.
Most definitely.
And Arts on the Plaza.
More community events.
Yes.
Yes, I'll be back real soon.
All right.
Great.
All right.
Thank you.
All righty. Up next, I think we have someone that's very familiar to us.
Step a very good buddy of mine, Heather Scherer from Fame Internet Marketing, also Chamber Diplomat. So she's here with a few things that we have both and all of us been working on at the Chamber.
All right. So we are really excited to introduce Leadership Douglas. You might be familiar with it, but Leadership Douglas is a great program that the Chamber puts on. And if you participate, you get to learn some awesome leadership skills. You get community involvement opportunities. It's just a really great thing for individuals as well as for our community. So if you are interested, you can go to the Chamber website and you can apply there. Those applications are due by March 15th. The website is douglascountygeorgia.com. Right?
You got it. Good job.
And while you're there, you can check out the new Member Information Center. We've got the networking calendar is on there as well, and the seminar series calendar on there, so make sure you check that out.
Great.
All right.
Good job.
Lots of things. Heather, thank you for always representing
the chamber, anybody.
And
yourself, your company, your family,
and a downtown business.
Downtown.
In the Douglasville area.
Yeah. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. All righty. Up next, we have
Tandra.
Tanya Canyon and
Tanya.
That's all right. She's back for which year is this now?
This is year number 3.
Awesome.
Number three, back in Douglasville.
Refresh all of our viewers about your event and what you've got coming up soon.
Okay, we are hosting the Tanda Canyon Empowerment Conference. It is a world-class conference. People come from everywhere here to the city of Douglasville. We do 13 empowerment sessions dealing with anywhere from family issues to finances, word and worship, prayer. We're doing a session strictly for prayer this year, marriage, which is a definite need in families now. We bring in world-class preachers and teachers, and of course, we have True Witness, who is right here from Douglasville. They're going to be with us again this year, so it's incredible.
Very cool.
Now, a lot of the event is registration, so you need to go out and register. And then several of your events in the night sessions are open to the public as well?
Absolutely. All the night sessions and several of our general sessions are open to the public as well. So they need to go to my website at tandacanyon.org or call us at 404-228-6969 and get that information. And we have a full schedule out there, but a lot of our sessions are free and open to the public.
Remind us of the date one more time.
That's March 3rd through the 5th.
Perfect.
Coming up upon us fast.
Coming up fast, right here at the Douglasville Conference Center.
Great. Okay. Well, we thank you for your continued support and keeping your event in our community, and we look forward to helping you get seats in your conference.
Absolutely. We'd love to have the whole Douglasville there.
Great. Right. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All righty. Up next, very familiar face.
One of our old buddies. We have one of our old favorites. We have Davina.
Hi, Miss Davina.
Hello there. How are you?
She's from the Cultural Arts Council, and you guys have just a few things going on this month in February and March.
We're off to the races in 2016 already.
Yes.
We have a great exhibit up right now for the African Americans for the Arts. It's a great event that their members have participated in, and it runs through February 26th, so we hope everybody will come enjoy that. And then our group, the DC Connections, has their afternoon with authors on February 21st from 3 to 5, a chance to meet local artists and authors and hear readings, and it's all free.
All right.
Cool.
Very good.
Yeah. And then, as though that isn't enough, and we're getting ready, so I'll give you an advanced preview.
Give us a sneak peek.
For the kids in March, we start on March 5th with a family concert of Smarty Barty's Arty Party.
Oh, wow.
Whoa.
Now, is this new?
This is new. This is our new Family Art Ventures program, and this will be a show with actor Barry Stewart Mann. And then 2 weeks later is always the favorite, Mad Hatter Tea Party.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. I can't believe we're already talking about all of this. Yes.
And 2 weeks later, we're going to bring a concert to Douglasville of the Big Chicken Barbershop Chorus.
Very cool.
All right. Stay tuned.
And go ahead.
I was just going to say, and if you want to check all that out, that's available on the CAC's website.
Yep. They can go to artsdouglas.org and check it all out and buy tickets already.
Yeah. Well, and also, just if you don't mind giving everyone your address, I mean, I drive past the CAC every day, but do you mind just telling people where you guys are located?
No. We're right across from Douglas County High School on Campbellton, 8652, and we're open 9 to 5, so come on over to the Big White House, your home for the arts.
Perfect.
All righty. We appreciate it. Yes. Thank you very much,
Davina.
Thank
you so much.
Boy, we've got lots happening in Douglasville.
I know.
You're kicking off with a lot of things to plan for your family, for your friends.
Yeah.
Right here in our...
I think I just filled my calendar.
We did. Hey, we'll be back with more City Connector right after this.
All right. I know this isn't any fun to talk about, but we should. Okay. So who's going to do what?
I'll pack the dead batteries.
Great.
I'll only put what I don't need into a duffel bag.
Perfect. That's totally unhelpful.
No problem.
Meanwhile, I will try to comfort everyone by speaking in a calm voice.
And I'll try to get the generator going without any gas.
Oh, let's not forget the cell phones, which probably won't work.
Right.
And who is going to handle supplies?
I can forget to do a list for us.
Thanks, pal.
Well, I think we couldn't be any less prepared. I'm proud of you guys.
Talk to your kids about who to call, where to meet, what to pack. Visit ready.gov/kids for tips and information.
Welcome back to the program. Now, February, a lot of cool things happen in February. Valentine's Day, Super Bowl maybe, is that coming up right in February?
Yes, I think
but
yes.
More important than anything, I think, is it's National Heart Month. So joining me here from Wellstar, Eric Sanchez. He's been through what we're going to talk about, the Academy. Cindy Spencer, nurse, right?
Yes.
And Josh Whitman. Welcome, everybody. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Now, they have been through, you've been through, you guys have been involved in the Heart Failure Academy, which is a new program at Wellstar. Right now, it's at Paulding and our local Douglas Hospital. It's going to be rolled out. So who wants to tell me what the Heart Failure Academy is?
I'll go ahead and tell you a little bit about it. We developed this program in order to give patients a better understanding of a heart failure and how to self-manage their own disease, to make them more confident in taking care of themselves and to prevent them from going back to the hospital. It's a 4-week program. The first week is designed to give them an overall assessment or an overall understanding of what heart failure actually is. We go over some of the signs and symptoms. We go over some of the medications that may be involved, how it's diagnosed, and just what heart failure means in general. The second week we focus on fluid prescription, mm-hmm. and then we focus on a nutrition, so a heart failure nutrition. The third week we're gonna focus on why it's important to weigh yourself with heart failure. We'll focus on medications that you're taking, why it's important to take those medications, and why it's important to keep your appointments with your physician. The last week we talk about exercise and behavioral health. Issues like mental health issues. A lot of patients experience depression, anxiety when they're newly diagnosed with that. So we have behavioral health. Yeah. We have behavioral health people that come and talk to them how to cope with that and provide resources for them as well.
Okay, so in real non-medical speak for me and everybody else who's listening, if you've been diagnosed with congestive heart failure by your doctor, you could go into this program and you're really going to give that patient a blueprint for what they need to know, how to help themselves, what they can expect, how to get the most out of their care. Would that be accurate?
That would
yes.
be exactly.
You give them all those tools that they need.
Yes.
Exactly.
Okay, great. Well, I have to ask, how are you involved, Cindy? And then I'm going to come over there to you, so be thinking about your answer there, Eric.
I teach some of the classes. I focus on educating them exactly what is heart failure, what symptoms to look for heart failure, who to contact if you have any issues with fluid retention and such.
All right, and what do you find with the folks who are in the classes? If they've first been diagnosed, and I would assume that they'd have to go through a physician and be diagnosed and recommended to the academy, right?
Correct.
So I just can't sign up and say, hey, I want to know.
Actually, you can sign up.
Okay. Yeah,
actually, you can just sign up.
Okay.
If you have had the diagnosis, I mean, there's no sense in taking it unless you have had the diagnosis.
Well, you may have a relative, maybe.
And we do encourage family members to take it as well. Absolutely.
Right.
I mean, a lot of times patients can't take care of it all themselves. They need the extra support because they're not feeling as well.
Right.
So family members are great to have with it.
So what are the most common questions, Cindy, that you heard when you were in there taking the class and giving the classes?
Probably their medications. They have to take a lot of different types of medications. They want to understand why they have to take so many of them. So we really break down each of the different medications, why they're on it, and why they need to continue to take it.
Because, you know, I know that with my in-laws, with my dad, you know, you line all those medications up, and it could be confusing. And what does it all mean to me? So you answer those questions.
In detail.
All right.
Absolutely.
Good deal. Now, Eric, you have been through that academy, yes, sir?
Yes, I have.
All right. Tell me, what was one of your biggest takeaways from going through the academy?
Learning what I need to do in my life to change things so that I can live a little bit healthier life than what I was.
Great. Like, for example?
Well, I learned about exercising, how it helps out, foods that I eat. Mm-hmm. And it teaches me how to take my medicine the right way, too.
Ah.
I'm very strict about taking that medicine the right way.
That is great. I think a lot of people, you're right, learn about this, or they're told they have congestive heart failure. And like you said, they could be depression. They don't know what to do next.
Right.
So I love that you take care of the mental health aspect of it as well.
Yes. Yeah, that's very important. Because the last class we started, January the 20th, we had a couple of patients that expressed their new anxiety they have because they had heart attacks, and they were very anxious about if they were going to have another one or what they could do. They were scared to push themselves too hard. So the mental aspect is a very important part of this.
Great. And what did you learn about the nutrition? When you said that they talked to you about the nutrition, eat more kale and carrots, was that it?
Well, yes.
I thought so. I knew it. See, I'm going to collect my own class next time. Eat more kale and carrots.
It's more food from the earth instead of eating a lot of meats and, you know, things that you have problems digesting.
Sure.
And the more vegetables you eat and things that help you out a lot. Helps me out a lot. I've lost 26 pounds since.
Well, hey, congratulations. Just by making those few changes in your lifestyle.
Just a few changes in the food and things that they have told me in the academy.
That is wonderful. Well, what would you tell people to expect when they come in to register for the academy the first time? What would you say to them? This is what we want you to take away from it.
I would say probably that you can live a very productive, healthy life even after the diagnosis of heart failure. It sounds like a really scary diagnosis, and we let them know that we can give them a lot of options to live a happier, healthier life than they think.
Anything you'd add to that?
I think one part is they hear the word failure, heart failure, and they think, well, their heart is failing, which is not necessarily true. Yes, their heart is not working as efficiently as it could, but it doesn't mean their heart has just stopped working altogether.
I love that. As a matter of fact, when you guys came up and you said the Heart Failure Academy, I'm like, what kind of name is that? The Heart Failure Academy. But that makes sense. Just because it is a diagnosis,
exactly,
doesn't mean there has to be some other type of sentence on you, right?
Right.
Exactly.
Okay, great. So how do people find out more information about the Academy and how they get involved?
They can actually contact us at 470-956-9752. That'll be my direct number, and I can give them the information that they need. We also are handing out flyers if they get to the hospital or anything like that. We're running an ad in the newspaper as well, so they can look out for it in the newspaper as well. But the main way is just to contact me directly, and then we'll get them set up with it.
Wonderful. I was telling you earlier, I sit on the Douglas Hospital Advisory Board for Wellstar, and I can't thank you enough for these kinds of innovative programs that really come out and take the citizens in and show us what we need to do, because I wouldn't have known a lot of that either, right?
That's true.
It was enlightening, wasn't it?
Yes, it was. Very enlightening.
Wonderful. So thanks so much for being on the show. We appreciate it. And thanks again for your good work in the community.
All right. Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
All right. We're going to hop out and listen to some more amazing talent, and then we'll be right back.
There's a shelter pet who wants to meet you. Meet one today. Visit theshelterpetproject.org. Adopt.
If my happiness depended on your affection. Cause you're
things you've done with your bike? Donating it to Goodwill may be the most incredible of all. Goodwill. Donate stuff. Create jobs.
Welcome back. You know, I love the segments that we have here on City Connector, but once in a while you have just one of those really feel-good segments, and I think that you're going to find that this is one of those. Joining me right now from Douglasville First Presbyterian is Melissa Cordle. Welcome, Melissa.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
And for the first time this year, First Presbyterian is joining with the Tim Tebow Foundation to host Night to Shine. And this is so great. This is a prom for special needs kids. Now, it's coming up February 12th from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. So tell us about Night to Shine and why the church decided, why you decided to do it this year, bring it to the attention.
A Night to Shine is a worldwide movement. It's to bring God's love and to show it to everyone. It's focused mainly on people with special needs who are 16 and older, and it is to make everyone feel loved. Each guest will be a king and a queen of the evening. They will be escorted by a buddy, and we just can't wait to show God's love to them.
It's really interesting because even though if you go out to the Night to Shine website, it says a prom for special needs kids. Like you just said, you have, 95 guests signed up?
We have 95 guests.
And the oldest one is?
63.
63. I love this. So anyone 16 and older who has special needs can come and be a king or a queen for the night.
Absolutely. We just need them to register and they can certainly come.
So tell us about what you do for them during that night to make it so super special for them.
Well, we're starting out with hair and makeup from 4 to 6 and shoe shine for the guys. That evening we have limo rides. We have food and karaoke and dancing and photo booth and just a lot of fun.
I love that. So really this is probably something that these types of individuals, adults and kids, would probably never get to experience on their own.
That I'm hoping that this is a very good experience for them.
I am thrilled about it. Now, what about if they don't have a date? Tell us again about the buddy system.
We have buddies for everybody. Everybody who comes gets assigned a buddy. And their buddy is just to hang out with them all night, dance with them, make sure they're feeling comfortable, have a meal with them, karaoke with them, just really hang out and just encourage them, and they'll kind of be beside them all night and just show them a good time.
So what really drew you to this, though? I mean, because there are a lot of, it's only the second year that Tim Tebow Foundation has done this, so it's relatively new. You were at First Pres the first church in Georgia to sign up to do it.
Yes.
You're the only church really in our area who's doing it. But what really drew Melissa to it? Why did you do this?
We're working on our outreach. We want to reach out. We want to reach people that we are not normally in touch with. And we have a very small special needs ministry at our church, and we'd like to expand it. And we think this would help us do that.
Right. Now, when you first reached out and applied to the Tim Tebow Foundation, what was the response you received from, how did that process go?
We had an application that we had to fill out with the church. We sent it in. We waited. Got an email in the middle of July, and I called my pastor, and I was like, hey, did you see that we made it? And he's like, no, I haven't gotten that email yet. So we were both just thrilled and excited.
So this really has been months in the planning.
Yes, we've started in June.
And how does it work in terms of formals and of the suits and the tuxes for the guys? How do they get those?
We had a prom wear, formal wear drive giveaway where we gave stuff to, we got stuff donated to us from different places. Mm-hmm. And then we had on the 17th, people came in and picked out dresses and clothes, and we had accessories and shoes. We had gave away about 40 dresses, I think, and all of our menswear. So
that's just really amazing. Do you have sponsors? How does this work?
No, Tim Tebow Foundation gives you a grant. And then anything over that, the church will be providing.
You guys take care of that.
Yes.
Now, I know that we talked a little bit about this off camera. Caregiving is hard.
Yes.
Under any circumstance. I mean, it's just really a tough thing. But in this case, they can get a night off too, the caregivers. Talk to us about your plans for them.
We have a respite room for caregivers and parents and anyone who wants to, who is in day-to-day contact and wants to come and see their special person enjoying the prom. And we're going to have a movie and food for them and different activities that they can participate in. We have some of our pastors who will be praying with them during the activity as well.
Just a great thing. So once again, we're talking about February 12th, 6 p.m. to 9 p.m.
Yes.
It is Night to Shine over at Douglasville First Presbyterian. But since this particular show will air all through the month of February, I want to remind folks that they can volunteer even after this year's event is completed, and they can volunteer for next year.
Sure. Sounds great.
Because how many volunteers do you have this time?
We have over 260 right now.
So it takes a lot of folks to put this kind of thing on.
It does. It's not been a simple task, but we are certainly rising to the occasion.
That's great. You're still glad you did it?
I am. And I get gladder the closer we get.
That is great. That is great. So once again, First Presbyterian at Douglasville. So if you want to get involved, how can they do that? Just call a church office?
Yes, that would be great. I have that number. It's 770-942-0710. And if you have a guest who wants to register, if you go to our website, it's www.fpcdouglasville.org, and they can register. Registration will close on the 31st, though.
Okay. All right. Well, wonderful. Once again, too, I want to remind people that's really beginning to grow. Last year, you said only 44 churches in its first year. This year, over 200 churches.
Yes.
So, well, thanks so much for doing it for the community. I can't wait to see photos. I looked at some of the ones on the Tim Tebow Foundation Night to Shine website, and those individuals just look like it is the best moment of their entire lives.
Yes, we're hoping to provide lots of those moments.
I can't wait to see that. All right, thank you, Melissa.
Thank you.
All right, good stuff. I told you, I have goosies because that was such a warm and fuzzy moment. So I look forward to finding out more about it. You guys stay tuned. Mark down some goodies from the interactive community calendar coming up, and we'll be right back.
Well, welcome back to the interactive community calendar. Sarah, who do we have between us? Two handsome gentlemen. What are they representing?
We have our friends from Leadership Douglas, class of 2016. And they are here to talk to us about their service project that they have coming up soon.
All right. We've got Mark and Wayne, correct?
Yes. Sorry. Right. I guess I could have done that part. I was just so excited about what they're going to tell us about.
Well, we're here today to let all of our veterans in the local area of Douglas County know that we absolutely love our veterans. And in doing so, we'd like to bring forth on February 20th from 8 to 11 a.m. at the local Chapel Hill High School, which is at 4899 Chapel Hill Road. A benefit breakfast to all you local veterans. We love you. We want you to know that. We appreciate you. And in doing so, we're going to have some special guests there, including our all-new mayor of City of Douglasville. Rochelle Robinson will be on hand to
Very
talk
cool.
with us. And we're going to have a lot of special guests and music to present.
Perfect.
Right.
And do they just need to show up, or is
show
there registration?
Show right up. Come on. Come all. And again, we're going to have some really good time. It's a time for us to hear it. At Douglas County, to be able to say, you know what, we really appreciate you guys and ladies that have gone out and done a great service to our country as well as to our community, and we want to say thank you.
Cool.
Right. So great opportunity. If you know some veterans, invite them to breakfast or to
Spread
the event.
Spread the word.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Spread the word.
Right.
Great.
Look forward to it.
And if people have questions or want more information,
who do
they need to contact?
They can call Mark, and that's at 678-386-2783. I'll be glad to take any of your questions and concerns.
Perfect.
All right.
Thank
you, gentlemen.
Just the beautiful face helping stand beside him, huh?
The support.
Do you have anything to add?
I do not. I think Mark has sufficiently covered it here.
Right.
Your PR person.
That's right.
Got it. Well, thank you guys so much.
Thank you, gentlemen. All righty. Up next.
Free breakfast for veterans. I mean, there's nothing that sounds bad about that whole thing.
I think that's
great.
Well worth it, and probably long overdue.
I was going to say, it's a great opportunity. Well, now we have Mr. Don, and he's here to tell us about some things that are going on at Sweetwater Creek State Park.
Our hidden gem in Douglas County.
Or not, if you've seen some of the movies that have been coming out.
That's true. Mm-hmm. What's up, John?
Right. Many Douglas Countyans have never been to Sweetwater Creek State Park. It's only 10 minutes from here. Mm-hmm. It's right off the interstate, Lee Road, exit 41. 2,500 acres, beautiful forest, the ruins of a Civil War era mill, 12 miles of trails, half a mile of whitewater rapids up to class 4. The big news is we now have overnight facilities.
Yes.
We have 5 tent sites and we have 10 yurts. They've been very popular and have definitely added a much needed new dimension to the park.
Exactly.
To call Sweetwater Creek's a real misnomer. It's actually a fair-sized river, most people would think, with almost 400 feet wide in some places. But every month, we do over 30 programs. We put out a sheet here, mostly hikes, but we're soon going to be entering into the paddling season.
So bring your kayak?
We provide that. Oh, okay. But sure, yeah. You can bring yours.
I was going to say, it's a one-stop shop, Kelly.
Kayaks, john boats, pedal boats, stand-up paddle boards, canoes, we rent those.
Okay, great.
But we also lead many programs on the creek and on the lake with a naturalist, a ranger, which runs for about 8 months throughout the season. Those will be starting in mid-March. We're excited about that.
Great.
Spring is coming.
It is, and what a great time to get out in the warm weather. So if we're looking to find out about those activities, where can we direct all of our viewers to find out more?
GeorgiaStateParks.org, okay. Or you can call 770-732-5871.
All right.
Perfect.
If you want to get active, make it happen at Sweetwater State Park.
Yeah, and even right. Now, I mean, it might be chilly, but that doesn't mean that you can't right. Go and hike and check out the beautiful scenery. What are your, like, your, it's dawn to dusk, what are your typical hours of operation?
Gates are open from 7 in the morning till dark, which is about 6:30 right
got
now.
It. All right. So not quite dawn, but a little close.
But a little bit.
Yeah.
So I'd like to mention we have a museum that's open 9 to 5. Mm-hmm. It's not only a museum, but a great gift shop. And it's one of the most environmentally friendly buildings in the world. It's a LEED Platinum building, and we actually do tours of the building.
Pretty cool.
All right. Okay. Well, go experience Sweetwater State Park.
Yeah.
All righty.
Right
Thank
here
you,
in Douglas
Don.
County. Thanks, Don.
Thank you, Don. I appreciate it.
And last but definitely not least, our little buddy.
And we talked about this before set. She's appearing for the first time with
as the brand new and
Jennifer
recently
Johnson.
Wed Jennifer Johnson.
Thank you for remembering.
Yes. Forgive us if we refer
I know.
Back.
We gotta make
to
a big deal yeah. About it.
Exactly.
Yeah. It's a big deal.
All right, Miss Jennifer Johnson, what do you have on tap for us today?
We have the bridal showcase coming up behind the veil. And it is at the Douglasville Conference Center, February 21st, from 2 to 5. So if you're a bride getting married or you just got engaged, it's a great show to come to. Lots of vendors from photography to
cater,
everything. Everything will be there. We also do giveaways. They do a drawing for two getaways.
Whoa.
I know. One to Myrtle Beach and one to Cozumel, Mexico.
What a great honeymoon.
Maybe I need to have a recommitment marriage ceremony.
Yeah, exactly.
Great.
Yeah, so it's a great show. It's good information, so we want everybody to come out. You can register online or call us, and we'll get you set up and get you registered.
Perfect. Is there a charge to attend, or is it free?
No, it's free. Free
Perfect.
To the brides to come on out and take a look at everything.
Okay, and let me throw you a curveball here because you do, it's at the conference center, mm-hmm. The conference center director here. How many weddings does the conference center kind of host on an annual basis? And just give us a little preview about how you have the capabilities of multiple functions there.
Right, we do lots of weddings, receptions, and ceremonies. We can do both at the conference center. So we probably average 25 to 30 weddings a year, so we do quite a few. Like I said, you can do ceremony, reception, or either or, you can do both. So we can seat up to 500, or we can do a wedding for 100. So we can do a little bit of everything.
Shameless plug, as we've already heard from Tanda earlier today, you also do conferences, workshops,
yes.
Small meetings.
Yes.
And do
parties,
you wanna,
birthday
party.
Parties, church events.
Any event. If you
Any
need
event.
A meeting space,
yes.
Call our girl.
That's right.
All right.
That's right.
Great.
Right. Thank you, Jennifer.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Right. We appreciate it. Wow, if that's representing
Whoa.
The first, what, month and a
yeah,
half or so
really,
of the
yeah,
year?
First, yeah.
Wow. What's happening the rest of 2016? Oh, my goodness. Well, we want to invite you, Sarah, tell them how each month they can join us to promote their organization and event here in Douglasville.
Yeah. Sure, you just can head on down to Arbor Place Mall on the last Tuesday of each month and meet us in the food court at 11:30, and we'll get you on camera.
All righty. We'll be back with more City Connector.
thanks so much for being a part of today's City Connector. There are a lot of wonderful things happening in and around Douglasville and Douglas County in 2016, and we hope that you'll be a part of it right here. Now, remember, you can find City Connector on Channel 22 on Comcast. You can find us on YouTube. You can find us streaming on the City of Douglasville website. You can find us on Facebook. I think we're out on Twitter. We're just about everywhere that you want to be. I encourage you to watch it, share it, and tell us how you love it. And thanks so much for being a part of it. Now, before I get out of here, we're going to hear some more from Emma Gwin. You've been hearing a little bit of Emma all throughout today's show. Welcome, Emma, to the show.
Thank you. Thanks so much for having me.
So I heard a little bit. You sound so fabulous.
Oh, thank you.
You're very welcome. So tell us a little bit about your influences. I sing Southern Gospel. What makes you sing what you sing?
Well, who's really influenced me the most, I think, in terms of my style is Adele, because she plays piano. All of her songs are really kind of slow and soft and sweet like that. And when I started writing, she was kind of the artist that influenced me the most.
Well, you can't go wrong with Adele. Did you watch her special? I'm sure you did.
Yes, ma'am.
In New York. I know. It was just fabulous. Such a talent. Wonderful. Now, how long have you been singing?
Well, I haven't really had professional vocal training since about a year ago, but my entire life, I started piano when I was 5, and I just kind of added singing to it, you know? And that's really how I fell in love with it. I ended up loving singing more than I actually did piano.
I love that. I think it was Lady Gaga, maybe, who said something like that. It was about acting and singing. And she said, I've always wanted to be an actress, but the singing came first. In your case, you wanted to sing, but the piano came first.
Yes.
Right? And you added that on. Do you write any or arrange any of your own music?
Yes, ma'am. All of the songs today that I'm singing are arranged by me.
Ooh, I love that. Wonderful. And what's going on with you musically out in the world? If we wanted to hear more from Emma, how would we do that?
Well, I do have a YouTube channel, and my songs are already uploaded on there. You can just look up my name, Emma Gwin, and that'll come up. And also my Instagram, which is also Emma Gwin. I post little 30-second videos and also keep updates about what else I'm posting on YouTube.
Wonderful. Now, why do you want to be, you're young, it's true, why do you really want to be when you grow up? Do you want to be on stage? Is that your ultimate goal?
Yes, ma'am. The dream is to be a singer, pretty much.
Okay. Well, wonderful. We love having you on here. You sound great. So I'm going to leave this to you, and I'll see all of you next month.
All right. Thanks. Thank you.
It's not your fault that I was in.
Bad combination. I'm better off this way.